at the ticket office at 1919 Caroline. Drop by. If you drop by today for your tickets for tonight, try to match your hand against Andre the Giant, this bronze of Andre the Giant. And if you do, we'll give you tickets to Sunday night's match and to next Friday night's match. But just remember, we have action on Sunday night. We have action on next Friday night. And there's plenty of it. And our ticket office is open right now. But listen to this interview now with Andre the Giant. Well, after more than 45 years in pro wrestling, I've become accustomed to being around big people, whether I've been wrestling them or talking to them. But no one ever, not ever, becomes accustomed to standing alongside of Andre the Giant and speaking to him. Not only does it give you a crick in the neck, but it gives you a profound respect for how big a man can be. And Andre, fortunately, is big inside as well as outside. Andre, we're glad to have you back again.
Thank you, and just like I said many times before, I'm very happy to come back in this area because I love to wrestling here and I like the people here too.
Well, you know, looking at you, I think you've gotten about 3 inches taller since I last stood alongside of you.
No, I'm still the same size, 7'4", and I weigh 482 pounds now.
Now you're 482.
Yeah, I gained weight a little bit.
Purpose on purpose or... just because you are Andre?
No, just like that, because I think I eat too much sometimes.
Yeah, just like all of us. Yeah. So you have the same problem that all other people have. Well, now, which part of your life do you like the best?
Oh, I like all my life. Yeah. I have a good time all the time. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, you have a good time because tonight you are in Texas and tomorrow you may be in Japan.
Probably, maybe next day after that in Australia. Because I'm traveling, I don't go all over the world. All the promoter wants me, just like you want me all the time. And yeah. I'm happy to go in all those places.
Now, before you got into wrestling, you were in other athletics, like football, European football?
Yeah, we call that in France football. You call that the soccer, right? Yes. I started playing soccer, I was 11 years old. I started playing in school, and I played that for 4 years. Then I played in 2 seasons for the rugby.
Uh-huh.
And I was a little bit in boxing, not too much. I was just for 9 months in the boxing, and then I come in wrestling.
Now, did you ever play basketball?
No, because in France, that time the basketball was not so popular.
Yeah. But wrestling was just a natural for you?
The way I come in wrestling, it was funny because when I go to the gym, when I was playing in rugby, all the wrestlers was in the gym too, and we training together. And they showed me the way to wrestling. But I was not interested in wrestling. And one day when wrestler was hurt, and they don't know who's going to take his place, then they called me. Mm-hmm. I said, I can't do that. I've never been in the ring in my life. They said, oh, we know you in the gym. You're so good and come try. Then I tried, and I was almost 13 years ago, and I'm still in wrestling.
And you haven't stopped. Have you played rugby since then?
No, but I still go back to see those guys. All the time I'm in France, the first people I go to see is those people.
You know, I don't think anybody has the dimensions that you have. Would you be kind enough to show these people what happens when you put your hand up there? Now, if I match my wrist with yours, just look at that. And your feet, I know that you recently had some boots made. How big?
22.
Only 22.
Tony Lama made that for me in El Paso. Mm-hmm.
You mean he killed two cows to make them, huh? Andre, I think that there is one thing that people escape. You are not just a big man. You have great coordination. You move like a 200-pounder. You don't move like a 482-pounder. You move with speed and with skill.
Thank you very much. And I really appreciate that because I know you are a great wrestler before, too. Thank you very much.
Well, I have great admiration for you in the ring and out of the ring. Your father was a big man?
No, my father is maybe 6'1". My mother, she's small, she's 5'1". But my grandfather was big. He was 7'8", and he weighed 520 pounds.
If he was here now, could I sign him to a contract?
No, he passed away.
Okay. Andre, it's wonderful to have you here. We wish you good luck.
Thank you. And anytime you want me, just call me. You know the phone number. Nice to see you.
Thank you. And don't be calling me for Andre the Giant's phone number because he probably won't be home, as he said, maybe tomorrow night in Japan or maybe the next night in Australia. He is that kind of an individual. But you have just seen one of the world's most amazing athletes, Andrei Rusmanov, Andrei the Giant.
And let me tell you another thing about this man, Andrei the Giant. Let me show you what I think of him. Well, anyway, Andrei the Giant. Andrei the Giant should be Andrei the Freak.
Everybody starts at ring number one. The object then becomes to throw everybody into ring number two. Once there are two men in the ring, in ring number two, the object is to throw everybody over the top rope onto the Coliseum floor. That then eliminates a man. When there is two men, one left in each ring, they then meet for the final prize money. Introducing to you, would you fellas get back against the rope so I can introduce you, please? Introducing Gary Young, Tully Blanchard, Tom Jones, Wahoo McDaniel, Don Diamond, Chavo Guerrero, Tom Pritchard, Scott Casey, Andrei the Giant, Bugsy McGraw, Bulzy Ramos, The Spoiler, Eddie Mansfield, Larry Lane, the masked, the twin devil number one, Mike the Big Gun, Tiger Conway Jr., Orlando Leon, Poland strongman Ivan Putski, and gorgeous Gino Hernandez. And now, let's go.
Well, you see a mass of men up in that ring. The object, of course, is to throw people over the rope into the nice, clean ring that is on this side of the one that's full of people. A lot of things happening up there right now. As you look, Bull Ramos in there looking. And incidentally, we want to tell you that the prize money tonight is $22,000.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ernie Land has been eliminated from this battle royal by the wrestling official.
And as the lone referee stands in that corner, Juan Reynosa, there is no doubt that he's looking for something to happen in his ring. Everybody tries to punish everybody in that ring number one. Look at the Giant standing head, shoulders, and a little bit more above everybody else in there. Gino Hernandez is sneaking around on the outside. He's going to work on Wahoo McDaniel, starting to blast away at him. But now, with Putski's help, Chavo Guerrero is laying a few, no, it's Lampago Leon, who is trying to toss Gino Hernandez over that top rope, and that then puts him into the ring that is nice and clean and devoid of people right now.
Big Mike. Big Mike is down on his knees, and Big Mike is being worked over by Tully Blanchard and the Spoiler. And here comes Andre the Giant, who just rammed heads together. And I tell you, if that isn't a mass of men, there's Bugsy McGraw being pushed over the top rope in the direction of the in the direction of ring number two, but nobody has gotten into ring number two yet. Vic Kozak has gotten out of the way of everybody. And, Gino Hernandez is off on the floor, and now he has worked his points and gotten back in and started to work on Wahoo McDaniel again. And Don Diamond riding on Big Mike in the center of the ring, 650-pound Big Mike, and Gary Young gets thrown out of the ring, and the you've got to be eliminated by being thrown into ring number two and not on the floor. Some of the wrestlers are on the floor.
Thrown over the floor to ring number one, you still have to be thrown over into ring number two from ring number one.
You see a lot of people trying now to get Big Mike, 650 pounds.
Oh! Mike the Bacon in the ring number
Mike
two.
Mike went over that rope and he literally poured his way over. Ivan Putski above me is wailing away at Gary Young. There are things going on here all over the place, but we've only got one man in ring number two, and that happens to be Big Mike. Big Mike is sitting down on him with his 650 pounds, and the referee, Juan Reynoso, is telling him that he's going to have to throw him over the top rope if he's going to do anything. There's Tully Blanchard. There's Larry Lane being thrown into ring number two. And there's a dropkick from Tully Blanchard at Big Mike. Now the Spoiler is on the floor, but he has not.
Tully Blanchard, Larry Lane,
top rope.
Wind Devil, all
now,
in ring number two.
Bodies are falling all
Scott
over the place as the people are thrown into ring number two. Putski and Mansfield, but the interesting story is taking place in ring number one.
As Marco, the,
oh, a tremendous battle there as Don Diamond and Tom Pritchard went mauling each other over the top rope. We've got Gino Hernandez thrown over by Andre the Giant. There are only five men left in, no, here's Wahoo McDaniel. There are only five men left in ring number one. Bugsy McGraw is thrown into the ropes and over the top rope and down onto the floor. But Bugsy McGraw is not eliminated yet. He is not eliminated yet. Here is Tiger Conway Jr. trying to hang on, and he does hang on. Andre the Giant works over Wahoo McDaniel, and look at that, towering above everybody.
Is
Tiger Conway Jr., who is
over,
he was on the back of Andre the Giant, and now it's Wahoo who is thrown. Whoa! And Andre is the winner in ring number one. Andre is the winner. We have Putski eliminated. We've got Tom Pritchard eliminated. We've got Larry Lane eliminated.
Larry Young eliminated, Larry Lane eliminated.
So Tom Pritchard goes up the aisle, Larry Lane, Ivan Putski.
Ivan Putski eliminated. Twin Devil.
The Twin Devil has just been eliminated. And the numbers start to dwindle. Relampago Leon, Big Mike has been eliminated, and it's almost possible now to determine some individuals in the group. And there goes Bull Ramos. Bull Ramos is going over the top rope, and Tully Blanchard.
Scott Casey, Tom Jones.
Oh, that's Scott Casey, I beg your pardon. Scott Casey has just been eliminated and will head for the dressing room. Up in the ring, we've got Chavo Guerrero, Tully Blanchard. Don Diamond has just been eliminated. There's Pugsy McGraw.
Don Diamond.
Gino Hernandez is up there.
Pugsy McGraw.
And, whoa, Wahoo McDaniel. And Gorgeous Gino are going at it. And the spoiler is almost over. And he is over. That rope, and now we've got five left. We've got Wahoo, we've got Tully Blanchard, we've got Tiger Conway Jr., we've got Gino Hernandez, and over the top rope went Chavo Guerrero. Tully Blanchard and Gino are on one side, and
Chavo Guerrero,
Conway Jr., and Wahoo McDaniel are in the corner right here in front of us. And we have the makings now of a four-way action as they try to out-psych each other here. Somebody has got to be eliminated for the dubious pleasure of trying to throw Andre the Giant over the top rope. Andre is standing above us watching. Ed, can you move the camera a little bit and show him Andre standing there and looking? There is Andre over in that corner watching what's going on. And it looks like he's enjoying having a ringside spot as Tiger Conway Jr. and Tully Blanchard are off on the floor just here. Neither one of them now have actually been eliminated, but Blanchard is trying to pull something, and there is Tiger and Blanchard blasted. Whoa! Tiger just missed a wild dive at Tully and went on the into the ring post, and it gives Gino and Tully Blanchard a chance to try to stomp Wahoo through the canvas. Now they're working on Tiger. Three in ring number two. It dwindles down now to Wahoo, Gorgeous Gino, Tully Blanchard. Listen to the noise. There's Wahoo watching closely. And Andre the Giant has just stepped over the ropes. He looked like he wanted to get in that ring number two. Nick Kozak. Don't dig it back where it belongs. And all right, Gino Hernandez trying to bottle Wahoo in the corner. And Tully coming in on the left. Gino coming in on the right. Here is the efforts of Wahoo with tomahawk chops trying to battle these two. Oh, nice. What a beautiful sound that makes when two skulls clash like that. Man down is Blanchard. Wahoo trying to face Gino Hernandez and still keep an eye on Tully Blanchard. And Andre the Giant has come in here to try to even things. He just couldn't stand it any longer. Blanchard is down. You see him where he was placed with a headbutt from Andre the Giant, but he has held on to Wahoo McDaniel's leg, rendering him immobile, and the duck soup for Gino. Gino holding on to him now to full Nelson as Blanchard blasts away at him, and They punished the Indian as solidly driving into him. And there is a lets him have it. There is a body slam that looks to me like, with all the tremendous weight we've had in that ring tonight, we've got a busted ring. But with 650 pounders, a 500 pounder, and a lot of people who hover around 300 pounds and 22 men, we've given the ring a lot of punishment tonight. Wahoo and Gino Hernandez trading blows. And Wahoo did not go over the rope. Here is Gino trying to push him. And Wahoo hangs on. He did not make the floor yet. He is still hanging on. He is
Wahoo eliminated.
There goes Andre the Giant. Andre the Giant wins the 22-man Battle Royal. He wins the $22,000 in prize money. He wins, and he has been a perennial winner. Not always, but he has not been eliminated in this event here at the Sam Houston Coliseum. Gino Hernandez, the last man to be eliminated by Andre the Giant. A great two-ring, 22-man battle royal. We hope you enjoyed it. We sure did.